Hello everyone. In last class, we have discussed about code optimization technique. This is also a part of code optimization, peephole optimization. So what is peephole optimization? It is a type of code optimization that is performed on a small part of the code. The small set of instruction or small part of code on which peephole optimization is performed is known as peephole or window. It basically works on the theory of replacement, in which a part of code is replaced by shorter and faster code without changing the output. So we replace that part of code by changing some instructions so that it will become shorter and run faster, but it won't affect on the output. Peephole is a machine dependent optimization. Objectives of peephole optimization: it is used to improve performance, to reduce memory storage, and to reduce code of size. In peephole optimization, we include some techniques like redundant instruction elimination. We have some redundant instructions in our code. Consider an example, like in this code we are calculating x plus y and assigning that value to z and returning z, except using a new variable z at this place. We can store this value in the variable y and we return the value of y. So we can further reduce this code by returning a simple x plus y, and we can further reduce this code by replacing the value of y on the place of y, x plus 10, and return that value. In this way, we can reduce size of code by eliminating redundant instruction in the code. Second is unreachable code. Unreachable code is a part of program code that is never accessed because of programming construct. Programmer may have accidentally written a piece of code that can never be reached. For example, void add 10 in text, return x plus 10, and after returning statement we are using printf statement here. In this code segment, the printf statement will never be executed, as the program control return back before it can execute, hence printf can be removed. So printf statement is unreachable code here, and we can remove this statement. Next technique is flow of control optimization. There are instances in a code where the program control jump back and forth without performing any significant task. These jump can be removed. As you can see here in this code, first we are using go to operation on L1, and at the place of L1 we are again using a go to operation for L2. So we can direct use L2. L1 go to operation is of no use here. So in this code, L1 can be removed as it passes the control to L2. So instead of jumping to L1 and then L2, the control can directly reach L2 as shown in the above optimized code. So this is flow of control optimization. Next technique is algebraic expression simplification. We can simplify our algebraic expressions, like a is equal to a plus 0 can be replaced by simple a, or a is equal to a plus 1 can be replaced by increase a. So in this way we can simplify our algebraic expression. Last technique is strength reduction. In strength reduction, there are operations that consume more time and space their strength can be reduced by replacing them with some other operation that consume less time and space and produce the same result. For example, x into 2 can be replaced by one left shift operator. So this is an example of strength reduction. We can replace a operator by some other operator that will consume less time and space. So all these are peephole optimization technique. What is basic flow and control flow graph? Basic blocks and control flow graph. Basic block means our source code generally have a number of instruction which are always executed in sequence and are considered as the basic block of the code. These basic blocks do not have any jump statement among them. For example, when the first instruction is executed, all the instruction in the same block will be executed in their sequence of appearance without losing the flow control of the program. We have a program can have various construct as basic block like if then else, switch case, conditional statement, loop, etc. So in a particular basic block, we will not have any jump statement. Basic blocks play an important role in identifying variable which is being used more than once in a single basic block. If any variable is being used more than once, the register memory allocated to that variable need not be empty unless the block finish execution. What is control flow graph? Basic block in the program can be represented by means of control flow graph. A control flow graph depicts how the program control is being passed among the blocks. So how control will pass among this basic block is shown by control flow graph. It is a useful tool that help in optimization by helping locating any unwanted loop in the program. One example for this, we have some source code. First we generate basic block from this source code, like our first basic block is w is equal to 0, x is equal to x plus y is equal to 0, and then if statement. So if part will come in another basic block, else part will come in another basic block, and at the end w is equal to x plus z that will get executed in every situation. So we have four blocks. We name these basic blocks like b1, b2, b3 and b4. So for control flow graph, we generate flow between this basic block. First enter, then b1 block is sequentially executed, and after that between b2 and b3 block, one selected block according to the condition will get executed, and after B2 or B3, B4 block is executed, and then exit statement. So this is a control flow graph that represent the flow between the basic blocks. Next topic is issue in the design of code generator. After code optimization, our next phase is code generator. Code generator convert the intermediate representation of source code into a form that can be readily executed by machine. A code generator is expected to generate the correct code. The design of code generator should be done in such a way so that it can be easily implemented, tested and maintained. This is last phase of our compiler. After intermediate code generation, code optimization is performed, and after code optimization, code generation is performed. So code generation is expected to generate the correct code. some issue arise during the code generation phase, like input to code generator, target program, memory management, instruction selection, register allocation issue, evaluation order, and approach to code generation issue. So first is input to code generator. The input to code generator is the intermediate code generated by the front end, along with information in the symbol table that determine the runtime address of the data object denoted by name in the intermediate representation. So input for the code generator is intermediate code generated by front end and symbol table that is used in every phase of compiler. Intermediate code may be represented mostly in quadruple, triple, indirect triple, postfix, syntax tree, or directed acyclic graph. We discussed all this in previous lectures. The code generation phase just proceed on an assumption that the input are free from all syntactic and state semantic error. The necessary type checking has taken place and the type conversion operator have been inserted wherever required or necessary. So we use error generator in each phase of compiler, and up to the code generator phase, all these errors are removed, and this intermediate code is error free. Next is target program. The target program is the output of code generator. After code generator phase, we get output, that is our target program. The output may be absolute machine language, relocatable machine language, or assembly language. Absolute machine language, like we generate .exe file as output, has advantages that it can be placed in a fixed memory location and can be immediately executed. Relocatable machine language as an output allows subprograms and subroutine to be compiled separately. Relocatable object module can be linked together and loaded by linking loader, but there is added expense of linking and loading that are like we use .obj files. Next is assembly language as output. Make the code generation easier. We can generate symbolic instruction and use macro facility of assembler in generating code, and we need an additional assembly step after code generator. So it can be target program can be in any form: absolute machine language, relocatable machine language, or assembly language. Next issue is memory management. Mapping the name in the source program to the address of data object is done by the front end and the code generator. A name in the three address statement refer to symbol table entry for names. Then from symbol table entry, a relative address can be determined for the names. In three address generator, we refer to symbol table entries for name, and their relative address will be generated. So this is another issue in the code generator. Next is instruction selection. Selecting the best instruction will improve the efficiency of the program. It includes the instruction that should be complete and uniform. Instruction speed and machine idioms also play a major role when efficiency is considered. So instructions should be selected in such a way so that it should be complete and uniform. Register allocation issue. Use of register make the computation faster in comparison to that of memory. So efficient utilization of registers is important. The use of register are subdivided into two sub-problems. First is register allocation and second is register assignment. In register allocation phase, we select only those set of variables that will reside in the register at each point in the program. Or in register assignment phase, the specific register is picked to access the variable. So first register is allocated and second register is assigned to a specific to access a specific variable. Like if we want to multiply two variable A and B, this type of multiplicative instruction involve register pair where the multiplicand is an even register and B, the multiplier, is the odd register of the even odd register pair. In one register we save a variable, or in another register we save a result after the multiplication. So this is register allocation issue. Next is evaluation order. The code generator decides the order in which the instruction will be executed. The order of computation affects the efficiency of target program. In which order code is executed will affect our efficiency of the target code. Among many computational orders, some will require only fewer register to hold the intermediate result. So we choose that way in which we use minimum register and that will give us effective results. So evaluation of the instruction order also matter in code generation phase. Last issue is approach to code generation issue. Code generator must always generate the correct code. It is essential because the number of special cases that a code generator might face. Some of the design goals of code generator are that we need to consider in code generation, like it should be correct, it should be easily maintainable, it should be testable, or it should be efficient to use. So we should consider all these factors during code generation phase. So all these are issues that come in the code generation phase. So this is all about code generation issues. Thank you very much.